provide the blended steps between the two. Now we want to edit this because this isn't how we want it to look. So if you double click your blend tool, it will give you the options and the options will come up. If they don't come up there, we're having problems, you can go into object, blend, and blend options in there as well. So that's two different ways to get to that information. What we don't want to do, we don't want to use the smooth color today. We want to use the specified steps. So I'm going to change the spacing to specified steps, and then we're going to edit this number here. We also want to make it in preview so that we can see what happens. So I'm just going to maybe take it down to say 50, see what that looks like. And you can see then automatically that we're beginning to get that sort of slinky type, spirography type effect where you can see between the individual lines. Now, if you wanted to, you could actually expand this whole thing so that you've got all the individual circles to play with. At this stage, we're not going to bother doing that because that basically is going to make it a little bit difficult because you then got all these individual circles and that might be too difficult for you to deal with. You can also work with the different orientations, but at this stage that isn't going to make any difference. So just click on OK and there you have a very simple blended line. Now if you wanted to try doing the same thing again, and I'm just going to, you don't need to copy this, I just want to show you what I'm going to do to just see, just an example to show how you can use this differently. We're going to just release that and try again. I'm going to get rid of that line in the middle. And just to show you that if I chose the different points on the circuit, it would give a different effect. So for instance, if I clicked on the outer point of the circle on that side and the outer point of the circle this side, the blend would become like this rather than like that. And obviously that can then give you a whole load of different options and things that you can do to play around with the different shapes. So just take some time to have a little play around, maybe try some different shapes and things. Obviously things like stars work well, or polygons and things like that can work really well. So have a little go maybe after you've done this tutorial, playing around with different shapes as well, because you can get some really interesting effects. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to get rid of that one because I've made a one already here, and I just want to really quickly show you how I made that example. So this one we've used a very simple two color interchange, and this one here we've obviously got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 different colors. So I'm just going to expand that to show you how I made that so that you can make that ready for using for your text. You don't need to obviously do this stage yet. I'm just going to release this and then show you what I've done. And in fact, what I'm going to do is just select those and make the font, the stroke, to 1 point so you can see a bit clearer. If ever you wanted to go back into your work and see what's going on underneath, so for instance I don't need this line but I can't select it any other way, it wasn't selecting when I tried to select it without going into preview mode. This is actually preview mode. The way that you get into preview mode from the shortcut is if you press Command and Y, it will turn the image into preview, or you can see up in view, and then you can go into overprint preview and pixel preview in there. So I'm just going to delete that one. And then what you need to do is select all of your circles. So hopefully you've had a go making your circles and dragging them out. At this stage, it doesn't really matter how far the distance is. It's just a case of adding in the colours. So you want, if you want to copy mine, you want to choose exactly the same colours. So the bright pink, the purple, the blue, the limey green, and then the yellow. So if you make your circles those colours, select them all, click to your blend tool, and then we are going to do a link between each one, stopping on each point before we move forward. So click on your top one, move to your next one, move to your next one, move to your next one, and go to the final one. And you can see it's not obviously set up as we want. We don't want this to be smooth colour, but again, this is a really good thing that you can use for blending and things like that with shapes in Illustrator if you wanted to have a go doing that. Click on specified steps, make sure you're on preview, let's try 50 again. Yeah, 50 looks good. So we're going to give it 50 specified automatically jump across for you onto your lettering. You see how simple that and quick that is to do. And now you have your letter W all made, ready to go. So that's the first one that we've done, and that's obviously a bit simple and not too difficult to do, so I'm glad that's been quite easy. The O is going to be a little bit more tricky. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to bring this down here, go into preview mode and just show you really quickly what's going on. So you can see we've got lots and lots and lots of circles all overlapped in there. And it's the same technique basically as the one above. I'm just going to actually release this one that I've copied out, and that way it makes it easier for me. What I want really is that center spine. Oh yeah, let's drag that out a minute and give that a color so I can see how big it is. And I'm just going to get rid of that. You don't need to obviously do any of this because you're not at the stage yet. So the next thing that you need to do is you need to create your larger concentric circles ready for replacing onto this, which is going to be your spine. So if I drag this one out, undo the blend, you can see how big my circles are. So my circles, if I open up the Transform Palette a minute, you can see how big they are. They are 46 by 46, so you could make them 55 centimeters or 50 millimeters is a good size for that circle. And again, you need to do the same thing. They need to be 1 point, doesn't really matter how big the distance is when you're drawing them out. Just make sure that you've got them all in a line. And then you can see I've actually chosen a different order, a colour order on this one. And the reason I did that was because when I made the circle shape, I didn't like the way it looked using this colour spectrum. So I changed it. So I did the green, followed by the orange, followed by the pink, followed by the blue, and then another blue in there. centre point going on, which sort of gives it a kind of more finished bit of a pow look. So what I've actually done here is another trick using the circle blend tool, and I'll drag those in so you can see. And I've basically just created another series of separate circles that I've added in to the into the middle. So again, you want to select your circle tool. It's best probably if to make your circle, you'd work within the actual area that you're doing it, so over your O. So if you want to just lock that, either by holding down up or two or going to object lock, that will hold that in place, and then you can work as you want from there. So select your ellipse tool by clicking on L or getting it from the toolbox, hold down Alt again, drag from the centre, mine wasn't quite in the centre but that doesn't matter, and then hold down Shift to get a lovely circle. I've made mine yellow because I think that works quite well. What I'm going to do is copy, which is Command C and Command F to paste on top. I'm then going to scale it by clicking on S and return to bring up the scale box, and then I'm going to scale it by maybe 75, let's just look on preview, maybe a little bit less, maybe try 60. Yeah, good. So we want to make that this the same kind of size as that. Click on OK and then select both of those. You want to make sure that your inner circle is blue if you're following the same colours as me, or you can try something else. Select the outside circle. And then we want to add in the steps between the two. So if we click on the middle one and then click on the outside, that will then let us create the blend between the two. Again, I don't know why mine isn't going specifically to the specified steps, but that's fine, we can just edit that now. And then you don't want too many circles here because you want to get this interesting sort of effect. So I've done 15. You could try something less, like 10 steps. You didn't want it too dark, but I think maybe 15 looks quite good because it gives you that nice pop of colour. So click on OK, and that's done. We're now going to repeat the same process, or you are. I'm not going to show you it again because it's what I've just created, only with a smaller circle here, this size. I'm going to fit that into the middle.